بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم، دس از مظفر کولاچی. آئی ایم کنڈکٹنگ سیکنڈ آن لائن سیشن، اینڈ لاسٹ ٹائم وی ٹاکڈ اباؤٹ وائی انگلش از امپورٹنٹ اینڈ ہاؤ ٹو لرن اٹ، اینڈ دس ٹائم آئی ہیو کم اپ وتھ اندر ٹاپک. ایکچولی آئی انٹینڈیڈ ٹو میک اے ویڈیو آن ہاؤ ٹو ریڈ ڈان نیوز پیپر، بٹ انفارچونیٹلی آئی کوڈ ناٹ فائنڈ پرنٹ فارم آف دیٹ نیوز پیپر، سو آئی ہیڈ ٹو چینج مائی ٹاپک. جینٹل مین، ٹوڈے وی آر گوئنگ ٹو ٹاک اباؤٹ واٹ is a sentence, what is sentence fragment, what is subject, what is predicate, kinds of sentence, compound subject, compound predicate. These are few topics. Now I am going to share a screen. You all can view that screen, view that PowerPoint presentation, and then in the end you can ask me question. Actually, this session is divided into two parts. First part, in the first part I'll speak only for the 20 minutes. In the second part, that will be informal part. In informal part, you can also participate and you can interact with me directly. You can interact with me directly and you can ask questions. Even then, if the session is over, my WhatsApp group is on. You can all the day, you can text me, you can ask me any question you want. Okay, now let's start it formally, and I'm going to share my screen now. Hopefully it will be visible to all of you. So now you can see that the main topic of today's discussion is sentence structure. This is the main heading, and there are subheadings or subtopics that are sentence fragment, kinds of sentences, subject and predicate, compound subject and compound predicate. Let's discuss sentence first. A sentence is a group of words that expresses a complete thought. Gentlemen, most of us have confusion in understanding or differentiating between sentence and sentence fragment. Most of us think that sentence fragments are also sentence. What we generally believe, or what we have been taught so far, that what is sentence? Combination of words is called sentence. That's what we have learned so far. So in sentence fragment too, combination of words are there, but that's not complete sentence. What is the difference? In sentence, there is combination of words, but it gives us complete thought. In sentence fragment, also there is combination of words, but it doesn't give us complete thought. Now, if you see sentence fragment is a group of words that does not express a complete thought, as I told you earlier. Let's move to a few of the examples. If you see out to lunch, there are three words. It's also combination of words. Is it a sentence? No, it's not a sentence. It's sentence fragment. If you see that in a spoken language, you can use sentence fragments because you know the context and the listener also knows the concept, context. But in writing, you cannot use these sentence fragments because it will not convey complete thought or will not convey complete message. Out to lunch, that is sentence fragment. If you say, I'm going out to lunch with my friends, that's a complete sentence. Because when you say, I am going out to lunch with my friends, it means you are conveying a complete thought. That makes it a sentence. And if you're just saying out to lunch, that makes it sentence fragment. Now if you see maybe later, you say maybe later. So if you say that in spoken language, that's quite correct. But if you say that in written language, that might not be considered as correct. Why? Because the context is not known. So in writing, I have written a note for you. In writing, a sentence always begins with a capital letter. Now all my cadets commit same mistakes all the time. Not all, most of my cadets. What they do, they start sentence with small letter. That's pretty wrong. You always have to start your sentence with a capital letter. And even after period, that we call full stop, after period you have to start sentence with capital letter. That's confirmed, and that's a hard and fast rule. You cannot change that. Every sentence starts with a capital letter. Okay, a sentence always ends with a punctuation mark. That punctuation mark may be
full stop that we call period, that may be exclamation mark, that may be question mark, anything.
So sentence always has some kind of ending. So if we are talking about sentences, then obviously there are many kinds of sentences that we have been taught and we have been reading since our primary, that there are many kinds of sentences. But most importantly, there are four kinds of sentences: declarative sentences, interrogative sentences, exclamative sentences, and imperative sentences. Gentlemen, here I want to add a very important point. I want to tell you that most of the English that we encounter are declarative sentences. And almost 70 to 80% sentences are declarative in English. Let's define what is declarative sentence. A declarative sentence states a fact. For example, the sun is shining today. Here, I have committed a mistake. That's a typo mistake. I have not capitalized the letter T. That must have been capitalized. The sun is shining today. So that's a fact. Okay, whatever you say, that is a fact. You state something. When you state something, when you state a fact, that makes it a declarative sentence. Here I have written down for you that vast majority of sentences that you encounter in English are declarative. Obviously, as I told you earlier, many sentences are declarative in their nature. In interrogative sentences, you ask questions. That maybe you ask questions using single interrogatives. You may ask questions using double interrogatives. Most of the people know that what are interrogatives, but very few people know that what are single interrogatives and what are double interrogatives. So let's learn what are single interrogatives and what are double interrogatives. Gentlemen, let's learn double interrogative first. All the WH sentences, all the questions that you ask with WH words are double interrogatives. And all the questions that you ask with, the question starts with helping verb, that comes in the category of single interrogative. What are exclamatory sentences? Any sentence that expresses a strong emotion, that is called exclamatory sentence. It's not always hurrah, we won the match. It's not always alas, my father died yesterday, something like that. It's not always that. Any sentence conveying a strong emotion can be considered as exclamatory mark, exclamatory sentence. But remember that there it must be followed with exclamatory mark. It must end with exclamatory mark. And now let's talk about imperative sentences. What are imperative sentences? Imperative sentences makes a request or command. Okay, either you request somebody or you command somebody. It falls in a category of imperative sentences. And few people have misconception that imperative sentences cannot be ended with exclamatory mark. That's pretty wrong. It's a misconception. It can end with exclamatory mark as long as it is a request or a order. If it's a request, and how would you come to know that it's a request or order? The force of utterance may also guide you in this way. The force of utterance, the way you say something, that also tells you that it's a request or order. Like you say, shut the door, that can be a request. That can be ordered to please knock the door. The word please is added here. It means it's a request. Now you see that this imperative sentence may end with a period or exclamation mark. Either you end imperative sentences with a full stop or you end it with exclamation mark. Earlier I told you that most of the English sentences that you encounter are declarative. Here I have clearly mentioned it, that declarative sentences are most common and interrogative are common, means second common are interrogatives, and exclamatory and imperatives are very rare. We rarely use them. Now, as we have talked about, let me review. So far we have talked about sentence. Okay, now we are talking about parts of sentence. There are many parts of sentence, but major there are two parts of sentence. One is subject, other is predicate. Listen to me attentively now. I'm trying to clarify one of your misconceptions. people, if you ask anybody, if you ask any student, but you tell me what is subject, sir, doer of action is called subject. Oh, kam jo kandar, subject hai, jo kaam karta hai jumle mein wo subject hota hai. That's pretty wrong. If I say mango is sweet, कौन काम कर रहा है इसमें, इसमें कोई काम नहीं कर रहा, तो ये किस तरह फिर ये सब्जेक्ट हुआ? तो आपकी डेफिनेशन तो यही गलत हो गई. इट्स अ वंडरफुल मूवी, हु इज डूइंग वर्क इन दैट? नोबडी इज डूइंग वर्क. सो डूअर ऑफ एक्शन, इट नलीफाइज द डेफिनेशन दैट डूअर ऑफ एक्शन इज कॉल्ड सब्जेक्ट. दैट्स रॉन्ग. डूअर ऑफ एक्शन इज नॉट अ सब्जेक्ट. व्हाट इज सब्जेक्ट देन? एनीथिंग दैट इज टॉक्ड अबाउट इन अ सेंटेंस, दैट इज कॉल्ड सब्जेक्ट. जुमले में जिसके बारे में बात होती है वो सब्जेक्ट होता है. द सब्जेक्ट टेल्स अस व्हाट द सेंटेंस इज टॉकिंग अबाउट. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड इन द सेंटेंस इज कॉल्ड सिंपल सब्जेक्ट. अब सब्जेक्ट आपको क्लियर हो गया कि जिसके बारे में बात होती है वो क्या होता है? सब्जेक्ट होता है. फिर उस सब्जेक्ट में फर्दर सिंपल सब्जेक्ट आते हैं, कंपाउंड सब्जेक्ट आते हैं, वो आई विल डिस्कस इट लेटर ऑन. जुमले का दूसरा हिस्सा, वन इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज सब्जेक्ट, द अदर इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज प्रेडिकेट. द सब्जेक्ट इज वन पार्ट ऑफ अ सेंटेंस, द अदर मेजर पार्ट इज प्रेडिकेट व्हिच इज द मेन बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक ऑफ द सेंटेंस. आई हैव जस्ट रिटन डाउन हियर ऑन पीपीटी फाइल, यू कैन सी दैट ऑन योर स्क्रीन्स, दैट प्रेडिकेट इज ऑल्सो अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ सब्जेक्ट एंड द अदर इज द बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक ऑफ सेंटेंस. लेट मी डिफाइन व्हाट इज प्रेडिकेट. प्रेडिकेट क्या होता है? प्रेडिकेट डिस्क्राइब समथिंग दैट द सब्जेक्ट इज आर डज. प्रेडिकेट क्या बताता है? सब्जेक्ट क्या कर रहा है या सब्जेक्ट क्या है, ये प्रेडिकेट बताता है हमें. द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड इन द प्रेडिकेट इज वर्ब. अब प्रेडिकेट में भी एक इंपॉर्टेंट हिस्सा होता है, उसको हम बोलते हैं वर्ब. तो वर्ब भी बताएगा ना. फॉर इस जो नीचे आई हैव गिवन सम एग्जांपल्स, यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट क्वाइट इजीली दैट हाउ वर्ब टेल्स अस समथिंग अबाउट सब्जेक्ट. सी दिस एग्जांपल. फॉर एग्जांपल, अच्छा, वन मोर थिंग आई वॉन्ट टू क्लियरिफाई दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल थिंक दैट वन वर्ड कैन ओनली बी सब्जेक्ट. नो जेंटलमैन, नॉट ओनली वन वर्ड कैन बी सब्जेक्ट, मेनी वर्ड्स कैन ऑल्सो बी सब्जेक्ट. ओके, क्लियरिफाई दिस थिंग. सी, टेक दिस एग्जाम्पल. माई यंगर सिस्टर अलीजे वंस वर्क्ड एज अ कॉस्ट्यूम डिजाइनर. इफ यू सी दैट माई यंगर सिस्टर अलीजे, दैट इज अ कम्प्लीट सब्जेक्ट. ओके, माई यंगर सिस्टर अलीजे, दैट्स अ कम्प्लीट सब्जेक्ट. From this complete subject, this Alize is simple subject. Once worked as a costume designer, I have underlined the white part of it. That white complete part is predicate. Why we are calling it predicate? Because ये हमें बता रहा है subject क्या कर रहा है, Alize क्या कर रही है. Once क्या किया Alize ने? Once worked as costume designer, उसने काम किया as a costume designer. अब इस predicate में भी एक चीज important होती है. सबसे important क्या है, हमें किस वर्ड से पता चल रहा है अलीजे ने क्या किया? वर्कड, यहाँ से पता चल रहा है. तो अब क्या हमने हम समझे क्या? हम ये समझे कि प्रेडिकेट में जो वर्ब होता है वही हमें बताता है कि सब्जेक्ट ने क्या काम किया. ठीक है, तो माय यंगर सिस्टर अलीजे, इट्स अ कंप्लीट सब्जेक्ट. वंस वर्क एज अ कॉस्ट्यूम डिजाइनर, दैट्स अ कंप्लीट प्रेडिकेट. अंडरस्टैंड? शी एंजॉयज क्रिएटिंग थिंग्स विथ हर हैंड्स. Now in this sentence only she is subject, rest of the sentence is predicate. And which word is telling us that she did something? Enjoys, telling us that she enjoys. That enjoys is a verb, and that's a pretty important part of the whole predicate. Now as I told you earlier that there are compound subjects and compound verbs too. Okay, so let's define compound subject. What is compound subject? A compound subject is two or more things that work together as a subject joined by the word and or the word are. Jab do subject ek saath istemal honge, do subject, usko hum compound subject bolte hain. Un do subject ek saath istemal ho aur wo jude hue ho word and or are se. Like in this sentence, if you see in this example, dogs and cats sometime enjoy living together. Now dogs and cats, दोनों ही subject हैं. Sometime enjoys living together, predicate. जो definition मैंने start में आपको बताई थी कि subject वो होता है जुमले में जिसके बारे में बात हो वो subject होता है. अब इस जुमले में आप देखें, dogs and cats sometimes enjoy living together, किसके बारे में बात हो रही है? dogs and kids ke bare mein baat hogi. Every layman can find out subject quite easily if you clarify this, if you keep this definition in your mind ke jiske bhi bare mein baat ho to wo subject hota hai. Theek hai, to is sentence mein aapne dekh liya kaun subject hai. Similarly, if you see what are compound verbs, compound verb is two or more verbs that describe what the subject does, joined by the word and or the word or. Predicate kya bataya tha? Predicate aapko ye bataya tha ki subject ke bare mein batata hai ki wo kya kar raha hai. Agar ek verb batata hai to wo simple verb hota hai, agar do verb milke batate hain, do verb batate hain to wo compound verb ban jate hain. Just look at this example. The giant tree bent and swayed in the wind. So the giant tree hai, the giant tree, that's completely a subject. Okay, bent and swayed, bent is a verb and swayed is verb too. So there are two verbs describing the one thing, the giant tree. When two verbs are describing the one thing, these two verbs collectively can be called as compound verb. So inshallah, we'll continue from here in the next lecture, and I'll see you in the next class. Till then, thank you so much. Allah Hafiz.